And but still, I mean, we're kind of in a golden age of television at the moment. So how it all shakes out is anybody's guess.
I'll tell you, when this goes to YouTube, you and I together, my server, whatever, who does it for me, will be broken up into four parts.
Okay.
In order to go their length of time.
Mm-hmm.
So it is the future, I guess.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's definitely a new way to get people information.
Who wrote the introductions to these various sections?
Sam wrote them.
Uh-huh. He's a very good writer.
He's a funny guy in his own right.
Yeah. He's not in the book, though.
He's not old enough to be in the book.
Ah.
we have a cutoff, 60 years old minimum.
Okay. Anything over, you're allowed.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. And who's handling, so Villard is sending this around the world under their auspices.
Yep, that's right. We're in bookstores. You can find us in Barnes & Noble and Borders and on Amazon.com and all that stuff.
Okay, and the next step for Eric Spiegelman?
Well, I'm going to keep, you know, we're experimenting with a lot of different ways to widen the reach of the video series. I mean, it's become something that we really enjoy doing, and we have a number of, we're going to keep collecting jokes.
Yeah. Have you had it translated at all, say, into Hebrew?
It's funny you should mention that, because we've had a lot of people ask us if we could send them translated versions, but we can't afford that kind of translation. And I just discovered a new website today where they have volunteer translators for video content. So I'm going to start talking to them and see if they can get our jokes in varying languages.
I have to tell you, I got the joke and it is very funny, and they'll have to read the blue ones on their own. will you autograph my book?
Absolutely.
And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.conniemartinson.com. Maybe we can all link in together. Those are all new words. And you can also visit me at talksbooks@lycos.com. On our website, you'll get linked in to Claremont Graduate University, the Peter Drucker Institute, that has digitized over 600 of the shows, going back to people such as Abba Eban, Gore Vidal in his early years, etc. And also Warren Bennis, people of a certain caliber for Claremont and for the Peter Drucker Institute. And some of the books we've been reading, Wendy Walker, producer. She has been the executive producer for The Larry King Show. And how they met when Larry did not want her, he wanted a guy who would know baseball. And Wendy came in, she had been working for Ethel Kennedy and for, I think it was Miramax, and she wanted to be his producer. And she convinced him that, yes, she would do a heck of a good job. Well, it's 30 years later, and she has done a great job. What she will do after he retires, she hasn't answered that in this book yet. And by the way, I should tell you that Old Jews Telling Jokes is on 3 CDs here. And again, someone's sick, give them this with, say, an audio version, and they will be able to laugh and maybe get better that way. Now, a wonderful book you've been buying, Bud, to drink. Do you think it's still Anheuser-Busch? No. Dethroning the King by Julie McIntosh is a terrific, it could be a novel. It's about the Bush family. Gussie, who was known as Gustav Bush III, he had the planes, he had the power, and he owned what he had. And he did not want to merge, he did not want to have anyone else come in, including his son, Augustus Bush IV. And it is a power struggle that whose team are you on? And then enters another company from Brazil. And this company has the money. And it is the era when companies are being bought out either friendly or unfriendly. And at the point that they become really enemies of a sort, they had been friends. There was no reason they couldn't have merged. But when Gus III said, all his people followed him. Now, where do you raise the money to compete at that point with European Belgium money? It ends up with, when you buy that Bud, it isn't from Anheuser-Busch anymore. The name may be there, but the company belongs to another firm. But just some of the books we've liked recently. Meanwhile, support your local library. Go in, take out a card. That is how they get funding. Take a child with you. Get them their first library card. They will never forget you. And they will learn that when you take a book out, you have to return it on time and in the condition you took it out. Eric, what did a library mean to you growing up?
Oh, I was in the library every week growing up. The Sherman Oaks Library of the LA Public Library right there on Moore Park. I was there all the time.
What were you reading?
When I was a kid?
Yeah.
I think I was trying to show off. I remember reading C.S. Lewis when I was a kid.
Oh, Narnia.
Yeah, I was into the Narnia books.
Yeah, and now, of course, it's being made into a film.
They have the film, but I mean, yeah. I certainly remember enjoying the books more when I was a kid.
Okay, with doing that and the exposure to films, do you see any of these jokes or old men telling jokes being evolve into a film?
Yes, we have learned so much about joke telling as an art form, the function of the various functions of joke telling, the various ways that jokes are used in society, that we have actually been taking notes and possibly doing a documentary on what we've learned.
Uh-huh.
We were it hasn't appeared on the site yet, but a couple weeks ago we were invited to a man named Milton Glaser's office. Milton Glaser, yeah. Iconic graphic designer, founded New York Magazine, invented the I Heart New York yeah. logo, and he's an avid joke teller. He's been telling jokes yeah. his entire life. And I interviewed him after the shoot, and he said that he had this great comparison to make between joke telling and effective graphic design. So jokes as a form of communication, I personally am very fascinated by it, and would love to expand.
Support that library, and we'll see you next time.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.